Fill the tank. Fresh gasoline sounds so much better. So yeah, I actually wanted to do a quick video, and I partly already did it. I tested the Firefly during a car ride. I haven't seen the footage yet, so I don't know if anything is usable. But yeah, I'm in a financial situation that I don't like to be in. Ooh, it's fresh, you can feel it. The last, I don't know how many months I've been driving on the same gasoline, partly because I couldn't see how much I've driven. I haven't driven that much. So yeah, it's good to ride with a full, fresh tank of gasoline. My car went for the yearly checkup. Now normally my dad and I do most of the repairs. So if there are some problems, it doesn't really matter that much. We can fix them, and we have fixed this car 2 times before. We have fixed the Peugeot, we have fixed a Daewoo, you know. My dad has been a mechanic in the early years of his life. This year it was quite a list. And if we do everything ourselves, the cost will be 550 to 600 euros, excluding tax. So yeah, 550 to 600 euros is manageable. Is not really what the car is worth, but it's still cheaper than buying a new car. But then the story came that one of the things that needed to be replaced was going over the gasoline tank. So that means we had to remove the gasoline tank, which by itself isn't a real problem. But the gasoline tank hasn't been removed for, well, ever probably. So the car is from 2002, so no, almost 20 years old. Not yet 20, almost 20 years old. The tank has been stayed there forever, and it used to be to a farmer, so there is a big chance he did some, you know, cruising around the land, his land. Also part of the fact that I've driven it almost 20,000 kilometers a year through every weather, including all the salt. So removing it is a little bit tricky. Damaging it means another 400 to 500 euros, estimated. We haven't looked into it, it can be much higher. That will bring up the total cost somewhere between 850 and 1,000 euros. That's almost the same price I bought for the car a couple of years ago, so that's not worth it. Letting it fixed by a garage means 2,500 euro is not worth it. Buying a new car isn't exactly possible at this moment. The financial room isn't there. So we have been looking into all the finance shit. What costs can we remove to make each month cheaper? What can we sell? And one of the things that my girlfriend keeps telling me, and she's obviously right, it's the bike. It can still fetch a good couple of hundred euros, easy, quick. It's, well, money wise per month is not that much. You have the insurance, which is quite low, and the road tax, which is also quite low. So that may be 50 to 70 euros per month. It's still quite a lot of money. So I can fully understand why she calls it, like why she says, okay, you can save on this part. Me personally, I don't want to, but it's a personal opinion. It's also a little bit because I like the vlog so much. I mean, there are days that I get riding just to make a vlog. Not because I have the urge to ride, but because I want to tell you guys something or share something or just talk to myself inside a helmet. Without any reason or point or logic, and just continue to go and go and go and go, and maybe something in the end is editable, probably most likely not, but it's a way to get my mind straight. So for me, it's also a way to get my mind straight, my head fixed. getting everything a place inside the puzzle. And so I really don't want to sell the bike, but it's a realistic option at this moment. One of the other options is selling one of the animals, a offspring that we bred. So that is our own captive bred animal, which in the end Bill has the intention to sell. But yeah, it's for my feelings and my opinions, I would rather wait a little bit longer until he or she is bigger. We know the sex is stronger. It's at least 1 year old. No, I'm not obliged to wait so long. I can sell it now. It's perfectly fine. It's within every rule book or care sheet or whatever. It's fine. I just, me personally, I just don't have the feeling yet. And that will also fetch some money. Upcoming Sunday, so I will try to edit this on Saturday, so you will see this for Sunday. But upcoming Sunday is Houten, the Reptile Expo in Houten. And I will be there. I will be there the whole day because I'm helping some friends who has a stand there, so we are selling multiple products. So I can easily, you know, help them sell some stuff. I can sell small stuff, but it's not bringing in big money. And that particular animal will bring in some cash. So yeah, we're still in doubt. We have decided that either we sell it up front and I will take it there, or we don't take it there at all. I'm not gonna bring it there, keep it there for how many hours I'm there, and then bring it back, because that's unnecessary stress. Now, I love my animals, so I don't want them to bring any unnecessary stress in. So yeah, that's one of the ways I can also make some money, you know, some extra bucks. But I do keep the animals' situation, the animals' health at first place. Normally as well, so we don't downgrade anything of the animals. They are, to a certain extent, more important than the bike. So we have changed, looked into the leasing of a car, renting a car. Now a lot of those situations are, yeah, how to say it, take too much time. It's not a quick fix, it's a longer period of waiting time. So that means I might sell this car, sell my car, then I still have to wait 4, 5, 6, 7 weeks before I can get myself another one. And that for me is just a little bit too long wait. I cannot get, I cannot be in a situation without a car that long. Partly also because of work. I have call-up shifts that I need to be able to be reachable. Me personally, I also like to do my groceries with the car because I can go to the cheaper shops. I don't have to, you know, stay in the local area and not dependent on the local shops. Of course, I can go 1 or 2 weeks without a car, that's not a problem. Maybe even longer, but not too long, because there are too many factors that are just better with car. Oh, they place these bumps and I don't know, of course it slows cars down, but the placement just isn't ideal. Either have to kiss the cars or drive straight to the middle. Both situations aren't perfectly safe for a motorcycle. But yeah, that's quickly my financial situation spilled out into an easy to go platform where everybody can see it. But the reason I am telling you this, because there is a chance, I don't know how big chance, but there's a chance that I might sell this motorcycle. I have no idea what will do, what that decision will do to the channel. So we are forging for money at this moment, and we will see where it will end. I do want to thank you all for listening to my jabbering. I'm gonna park right here next to the church, and I will see you guys very soon. So yeah, thank you for watching.